Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
All right, welcome back, everybody, to another Vintage Masters draft. We have one day left with the old clients, so I'm trying to get a few of these in to bid it adieu. This pack is not super interesting. We have a couple of choices. We can take a Lightning Rift and go the Cycling deck. It's kind of nice to have a Lightning Rift that early, especially since it's probably the more important piece compared to Astral Slide. We can take Swords to the Plowshares, which is a generically good card. Enjoy that. We could take a Regrowth, which is a little less generic, but pretty good card. Expunge is an option, but I'll take Swords over that. I kind of want to just take the Lightning Rift. Swords is quite strong, though. But there are some decks in the format that just don't care about it, too. I'm going to take the Lightning Rift. It's a more fun card to take. We'll see if anything comes out of it. Well, this second pack's not very good. There's a Badlands. No cycling cards. Fintorn Elf, I suppose, is an option. Nature's Lore. If I'd taken Swords, what would my pick be? I guess this guy, probably. I guess I could just... I really don't want any of this. I think I'm just going to take a Badlands. I think it lets me, like, maybe splash a Cycle Land or something. Ooh, there's a Hermit Druid, Anime Dead, Chartreuse Cougar, Crimson Tusker. What do I take here? There's also a Resend. This grabs Badlands, so I kind of want to take it. But at the same time, I'm going to have other opportunities. This doesn't really... I mean, this is kind of its own strategy. It goes better with something like Anime Dead. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Cougar and play it safe. We'll see what comes up. There's this guy who's relatively safe. There's this card. Sorry, Claws of Wirewood. I had a request from some people to start saying card names in case they weren't watching the screen. I don't know why you would just listen to me, but I guess some people enjoy that. So, Noble, Templar, and Claws of Wirewood are kind of our options here. I could take a deep analysis, but not too inclined. The only red card is Skirk Prospector, which is not very exciting. There's a Yavimaya Elder. But I'm just going to take a Claws of the Wirewood. Let's see if that goes anywhere. There's a Breath of Life, which is pretty good. Also, Afterlife, Death Grasp. There's quite a few good cards here. Alright, so Noble Templar is reasonable. Breath of Life is reasonable because it's a white card that lets me bring back fatties that I cycle away. Death Grasp is reasonable because I already have a Badlands and a way to fetch up Badlands. So if I'm red-white, I could easily splash that. Which might just be the best choice, to be honest. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Death Grasp, I think. And then maybe we'll re-evolve Diffusion. That'd be nice. Breath of Life would be pretty reasonable. I would certainly not be sad to have a Breath of Life, but it is what it is. Alright, Tranquil Thicket, Phantom Nomad. This pack's just not very exciting. I guess I could take this Elvish Aberration. It cycles. We have a Claws of the Wirewood, so maybe we'll play like one or two Forests or something. Tranquil Thicket, something like that. We're not really... Ooh, there's a Stoic Champion. That's a big game. Multiple cycling cards here. Stoic Champion's the harder to find of the two, so I'm going to take it. Renewed Faith is a card you definitely want some number of in your deck, but I'm going to take the Stoic Champion. It's kind of like our first slide, if that makes any sense. All right, I could take Sky Shroud Forest. I think I just want a Faithful. I could take Nomad too, but I think Faithful is better with Astral Slide. It's also a better defensive card. Sky Shroud Forest would be... reasonable option, but I don't think I'm going to play blue. If it tapped for green, then I would... Like, Any green land I can grab the Elvish Aberration obviously goes up. A green white land or a green red land. But, alright, what do we have here? We have another Elvish Aberration. It's not an aberration, it's an aberration. I could also take Mana Prism, which lets me splash all these things, but I think I'm just going to take the Cycler. Like, you find one of these, it gets you your forest, and then you can cast the additional ones if need be. So, having two aberrations and a Claws of the Wirewood, like, one forest works for all of these. It's pretty nice. Flowstone Hellion, Mistmoon Griffin, or Nature's Lore. I kind of like all these cards. I'm just going to take the Hellion. It's a 5-mana, it's a 5-power haste creature. The turn you play, it's a 5-1. And then a 3-3 after that, which is pretty reasonable. I could see taking the Nature's Lore, but I don't expect us to be heavy green. Like, we would have to get so many Tuskers to make that worth our while. I just don't necessarily see it happening. Here's a white-black land in Salt Flats, which will let us splash the Deathgrasp very easily between that and Badlands. So I'm going to take this. Wall Diffusion and Tranquil Thicket would both be reasonable, I think, but happy to take Salt Flats there. Noble Templar Wheel, that's sweet. Both Noble Templars and the Breath of Life. Alright, I'm going to take the Breath of Life now. We have two Elvish Aberrations, a Chartooth Cougar, and a Noble Templar to return with this Breath of Life. So, that gives us a nice little secondary plan, I guess, if you will. So right now, rewards for cycling include Breath of Life, Stoic Champion, and Lightning Rift. And we're only one pack in, and we already have three kind of reasons to do it, which is nice. So from this point forward, we do need a lower curve. You can see we have some two drops and then a bunch of expensive things. Granted, all this oh my gosh. That was insane for us. Easily the best card that could have come back. And with that, I feel pretty good that no one else has an Astral Slide, so it's late enough that if we get an Astral Slide going around, we'll probably be the ones that get to snag it up. This pack is not very good, however. There's an Icarid. How much is Icarid worth? I don't think it's worth anything, but I'm going to look. Icarid is one. I'll probably just take the Battle Screech here, then. As lame as that is. Nothing else. This is just a bad pack for me. Like, not interested in any of these green cards. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Battle Screech. Battle Screech is a good card. I'm just not going to be able to do much with it in my deck. It's the only problem. But it is what it is. I could take a Blazing Spectre here, but I don't want to go too heavy on this black thing. I think I just want to take Trapper. It's a cheap card. It's a defensive card. Expunge would be a reasonable choice after the Trapper, I think. Like, I wouldn't mind playing an Expunge, but Trapper is 100% on color, whereas, again, that's another splash card. But I'll definitely take an Expunge if a pack shows up where there are no on-color removal or whatever. Wow. Alright, big game here. I think we just have to take a Balance. I can't pass a Balance. Seems too sick. There's all kinds of cards for us. Spark Spray and Forgotten Cave are probably the next two best ones. Goblin Settler is reasonable, though. And even Chainer's Edict is reasonable. But I'm just going to take Balance. I don't know if it's worth anything, but it's a super powerful card. We don't really have a way to abuse it as of right now, but we'll figure something out. What does this card do? Beginning of each upkeep, put a Strife counter on this. Attacking creatures get +1/+0 for each Strife counter on it. Blocking creatures you control. So the attacking creatures thing works for everybody. That's weird. It's a weird card. Crows and Tusker is reasonable. I think I'm just going to take Mana Prism, though. It's another Mana Fixer. Baron War would be another option. But I think snagging this while I can. Neither of these cards are super great for me. So I think Mana Prism's solid there. What do we have here? We have a Goon, an Afterlife, a Commando. A Walled Diffusion. I think I'm just going to take the Afterlife. I like having a couple of these in my Lightning Rift decks because it lets my Lightning Rift kill off their big creatures. Commando is reasonable, but we don't really need ways to kill small guys at this point, I don't think. So, Afterlife it is. There's nothing for us here. I guess I'm just going to take this Pine Barrens. It's a black green land. I'll play it. That and one forest. I don't want a shelter. Yeah, sure. Aftershock's kind of nice. Gildelight. I probably want the first Gildelight more. Maybe not. Maybe want the Aftershock. I could probably get one Gildelight later on. Aftershock's pretty nice to have as a one of. Yeah, I'll just snag that. I haven't seen any other Aftershocks. Another Breath of Life or Secluded Step. How many? Still the big four Cyclers. Yeah, I think I'm just going to take the Secluded Step. We haven't got any Cycle lands yet. It's kind of free value, just sitting there. Alright, I guess I'll take a Nicorid. I don't want anything out of this pack, so I'll just take the rare. I have no other explanation. Another Blazing Spectre opportunity. I'm just going to take this Secluded Step once again. For the exact same reason. Free land. Same with this Forgotten Cave instead of the Spark Spray. Spark Spray is pretty good, though. I won't deny. Our red is actually very minimal. We're like... Maybe I shouldn't have even taken the Aftershock. I assume we were red because of this Lightning Rift, but at the same time, our red is very light. Maybe I should have just taken the Crows and Tusker. That's not a huge deal. We have plenty of playable, so I'm not worried about having a deck. We maybe could have had a slightly better deck. We haven't seen an Astro Slide yet, which is kind of lame. Sure. I don't think I'm going to play the Sudden Strength. Alright, I'm going to snag the Commando. It came back along with Wall Diffusion. This will go better with a Astral Slide if we get there, and we also don't have many fives, so I'm happy to pick up a guy that shocks. Wall Diffusion's nice, but we're only going to want like one of it, and I think we'll be able to snag it in the last pack. I'm going to leave that there. Just ooh, the Gilded Light Wield. Nice. So we're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 21 playables. I could easily cut green, I could easily cut red, I could easily cut black. Woo!